Hello friends, I am Bharati from www.learnlikeachildren.blogspot.com. In the series of daily one question or passing question or important question, today I have selected the topic circle. In circle topic, I have selected a theorem that is for 3 marks. The question is, or the theorem is, the length of tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. So now we see how to represent this theorem systematically, and before that how we understand this theorem so that we can represent properly in the answer sheet to get full marks. So let us start it. First, let us understand the statement of the theorem, and same time just to select 2 words from this statement which you feel very familiar for you to remember. Okay, if you want me to suggest 2 good words from this statement, I'll suggest you first an external point, because if you remember external point, certainly you will jump to this theorem, because this theorem is based on the tangents drawn from an external point. So external point is the very, very important word in this statement. One more thing, tangents, because here in this theorem we are dealing with theorem. Tangents. So tangents and external point, you can join these 2 words, no problem, but still external is the perfect word to remember. So tangents and external word you can remember. When you see tangents and external word in your theorem, start writing this diagram. Wait, to draw this diagram, no need to remember the whole diagram in your mind, but you just read the statement, accordingly you draw the figure. Okay, let me help you to draw this figure. Now you divide this statement into 2 parts, first half and second half. From the help of first half statement, you just draw the figure, and from the figure you just draw the data. Both the things would go simultaneously. Let's see how. Now, the length of tangents drawn from an external point to a circle. It means first we need a circle. Yes, we have drawn a circle. To this circle we have to draw 2 tangents. From where? From an external point P. In this way, if you start thinking, automatically you will come to this diagram. Okay, now our diagram is ready. We have a circle, we have an external point, and we have 2 tangents. That's it. The same thing I would prefer to write in a mathematical statement. That is nothing but data. First, what I would see in this figure? I see a very simple circle with center O. It means O is a circle. Circle, comma, and P is an external point. O is a circle, P is an external point. PQ and PR are 2 tangents. Only this much is visible in this figure. Now, you might be surprising, 2 3 more lines are there, but right now they are not needed. Only this much is visible in the figure. Next, to prove. To write this heading to prove, we need next half of the statement, that is R equal. R equal means what? What are equal? Okay, two tangents are equal. That much only we have to write in to prove. What is the name of those two tangents? Yes, PQ and PR. These two tangents have to be equal. So I have put here equal sign. That is our to prove. Next, construction. Construction part is very simple. Just I have joined the remaining three lines. Those are OP, OQ, OR. Here you just add a word, join. Join OP, OQ, OR. OP is distance between center of the circle and an external point P. OQ and OR are radius or radii. That's it. Construction is over. Next, we will move to proof. Proof consists of only four headings or four parts. It's very simple. Let us do it. Now, let us see how to prove the statement or to prove part of the theorem. Okay, first, let me take two triangles here, O, Q, P and O, R, P. Of course, there are two right angle there are two right angles. Here, Q is the right angle. It means its value is 90 degree because OQ is the radius and QP is the tangents. We know that radius and tangent are always perpendicular to each other. So here we'll get 90 degree angle. Similarly, R is also a right angle triangle. So better we call this triangle as right angle triangle. Okay, let me write right angle triangle O, P, Q and one more right angle triangle, that is O, P, R. Okay, in OPQ and OPR, let us see what are the equal points. First, we can take these two right angles only, that is OQP. This angle is equal to ORP. Reason we have to mention here, that is these two angles are right angles or their value is equal to 90 degree. This is first condition. Second condition is OP. What is OP? OP is common to the upper triangle as well as lower triangle. It means these two triangles have OP as common side. Okay, as it is construction, it is common side. It is common side not because of construction, it is common side because both these two triangles share this side. Because of that, this line is common. Okay, let me write it. OP is equal to OP. Why? OP is common side. Common side. Okay, let me take one more point, that is OQ equals OR, because OQ and OR are radii radii of the circle. We know that all the radii drawn in a circle are always equal. You just compare the circle and radii with the spokes of your bicycle wheel, because all the spokes of the bicycle wheel are equal. You can compare your radii with spokes. So as spokes are always are equal length, similarly here radii are equal. Because of that we have written as OQ equals OR. They are radii. Here it is third point. Okay, now we have written 3 points. Because of these 3 points, all triangles that we have already selected, OPQ and OPR, congruent. What is mean by congruent? Congruent means if you say two triangles as congruent, it means they are equal in all respect, in respect of angles as well as sides. So let me write right angle triangle OPQ is congruent to right angle triangle OPR. Here let me put congruent sign. Congruent sign is equal, a just simple alphabet S is sleeping on this railway track, you can say. This is equal, this is sleeping S. Totally we call it as congruent. Now what is the criteria that postulate we have used to prove these two triangles as congruent? Means first one we have used equal angle, this is side, similarly this is also side. So here we have used S, A, S. Put single A in between two S's. So S postulate we have used to show these two triangles as congruent. Okay, our work is almost done. Now what we have to write? We have to write PQ is equal to PR. Directly you can write, because when these two triangles are congruent, then all other parts of these two triangles are simply equal to each other. On the basis of this postulate or this condition, I have written PQ equals PR. What is the reason for this? CPCT. It means corresponding parts of congruent triangle are always equal. So here we have shown these PQ and PR are equal. What are these PQ and PR? Obviously, PQ and PR are tangents. It means these two tangents are equal. That is the proof of the theorem. In this way, you can prove this theorem. And it is perfect representation also. You can write it one or two times and remember these two relevant words. Similarly, you can share this thing with your friends by telling them orally or explaining the same theorem on the pages. Let them understand and both will be benefited. So friends, if you like this video, you please give your thumbs up, share with your friends, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel so that I can send you notifications of my upcoming videos. Thank you.